today we're going to do something kind of different. Today we're going to be working on an IndieDB post. So part of development for a game is getting the game out there, and that's what we're going to be working on today. So I've already gone ahead and made the jig. It's kind of going to draw some attention to the post. So it's real simple. It's just, you know, it's literally two frames, but the fact that it moves is just going to draw some attention. Now, the way I do this is I usually write up the post in HTML. Basically, this post is going to cover a couple things. It's going to cover up the recent post that I did discussing the life update, the replay video. Usually I don't do these kinds of, just text posts. So this is going to take a little bit of work. But I think what I want is I want an image on the left and a body of text on the right. So let's try. Center. I don't think I want that. I want this to be left aligned. So here's a div. It's 100%. Let's see what this looks like. Still putting the text under. Does that look like that inline it?
pure, purified.
little bit of a pressure during that transition.
Moito with their interpretation of the classic track Akamar, such a fun version, I love this one. As I mentioned previously, I've got a few weeks off touring to concentrate on projects and finish stuff before the touring starts again, and also some holidays. I can't remember last time I was, so much looking forward to just relax and unwind a little and be out in nature. This will be so good for me, I can't wait. And then I'll be back on the road again middle of February, and I've got lots of dates locked in already and can't wait to share the touring schedule with you in a few weeks on Facebook or Instagram, Twitter, you'll hear about it for sure. Up next is a track from Woods with Desert Storms, Doris Vaughan on the remix, really uplifting melodic track.
Representing the Helvetic Nerds with the finest indie dance and deep house music.
Here. Okay, so if you take a look at the article section here, there's lots of GIFs for the game, and every time I've done an update, you know, I have a nice animated image. And so if we look at like the Undead Mages update, we've got our header image, and then we go through all the abilities that were updated. This is a lot of work, but it's worth doing. I think it really shows the quality of the game. This has gotten, you know, 354 views. It's something. So it's going to be quite a bit of work, but we're gonna do this for the dwarves, since we just finished updating the dwarves. So I'm going to create a new folder here for the next ADDB post. So I'm going to work on this today.
The pure
I'll probably
discovery.
Put it up in about 2 or 3 days from now, just to keep us up on ADDB. And by then, I should already be back to working on dwarves. Ahead of where the ADDB post is. So I'm gonna copy this, throw it in there, we can close that, open this in Notepad++. Now first thing we need to do is to record some additional recording software that I was using. Let's see what it was. testing map at the battlegrounds, and let's go ahead and rebuild that client. In the meantime, we can go ahead and all the abilities that we need to cover. There's quite a few. And then we're also going to have to update the website. We've got an up-to-date roster of units and abilities. And so we have to update all the information here.
Presenting the Helvetic Nerds with the finest indie dance and deep house music.
Just looking at random Reddit stuff. get that game server up. Get my cat sitting on my lap as usual. Good day. And I've got about an hour left to work before I have to head out to the gym again. Okay when he doesn't have looks okay when he doesn't have the shield, but okay, so let's do this again, just for now. And I think what I'd like to do is add some code where, you know, during the casting animation, he hides his weapons, that something like that. But for right now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to hack this a little bit. So I'm going to go to the... Where is it? The skin manager. And... So we've got the dwarf hammer, dwarven defender. We're going to get rid of that one for just a minute. And let's go ahead and launch that again. And we should get a dwarf without the shield. Center. position this so that I can have saltier on the bottom here. I don't like this spot super much. Let's try this again over here. So I want the hammer to be visible, but I also want enough room for the text. And I think that's a decent compromise right there. So let's go ahead and record at 30 frames per second. Stop it at 8 seconds. Save this as a GIF. And we're going to throw this RTS images for casting promo. And let's see how big that is. Because AnyDB does have a limit to how much you can upload. Let's go back to articles, post article. So 8 megabytes max is what we're looking at there. So we can go ahead and the first thing we can do is edit this and we can just reduce the duration. So let's save this again.
Representing the Helvetic Nerds with the finest indie dance and deep house music.
You just heard the amazing Homegrown from Hawks with Thomas Jack on the remix, who's going a little deeper recently, and I'm really enjoying it. Thank you guys for tuning in. You can always check this week's episode again, as well as all previous shows, on your favorite podcast app. Just look for Purified Radio and remember to subscribe. This final track is Einmusik with Mann. I really love this guy's productions. He always managed to create an incredible vibe in it, also in this one. Looking forward to catching up with you again in a week for another installment of Purified Radio.
You're listening to Noram Pure Purified.
There. It's still a little bit big, so let's free transform, shrink that just a little bit more, and center it once more. There we go. Then we're going to add a stroke that's a little bit too heavy, and I like to add an outer glow that's white. It's quite large, and I like to use overlay, which is like a subtle way to make it pop. Look at this frame to frame, it disappears after the first frame. So by clicking this and this, it applies it. I don't know why Photoshop does that, but it applies it to everything here. Now let's compare that with our Lich image, just to make sure everything looks good. Saturation. Let's see, is it this? here's the saturation adjust, okay? So let's bring that saturation up a little bit. Let's see how that looks. Because it's a little bit dull. Let's bring it up a little bit more. A little bit brighter, good. We want this to really pop because it is kind of a dull image. Good, almost there. A little bit more. All right, now let's bring the contrast up a little bit. See how that looks. That's a bit too strong, so let's dial that back a little bit. And I think we should be pretty happy with the result here. Looks like the contrast takes a little bit longer for it to process than the saturation adjustment there. That's a little bit brighter. I like that. Okay. So now let's optimize this. And right now it's a little bit too big, so let's compress that and see if we can get that down to 8 megabytes. Okay, so that's 10 point something. Let's compress that a little bit more. So despite our compression there, we're not getting the reduction that we need. So I'm going to save this image and just drop some frames.